We've seen more news about sinkholes recently. What's happening and can this be prevented? I'm Chan Yu-im and this is Dr. Wu Wei, and today we're answering your questions about sinkholes. What causes sinkholes?
Sinkholes commonly formed due to the dilution of soluble minerals and rocks, such as limestone. This is a piece of limestone. You can see many voids on the surface. This is because of the acid water dissolved minerals and left the holes. Similar on, in the case on the ground, the acidic groundwater or rainwater will dissolve the minerals and create openings. And the openings can grow, expand until approaching the ground surface. So let's say this is a flat ground surface. If the cavity is developing on the ground, we will not see any change on the ground surface. But during this process, the cavity grows, getting larger, and we will see a sunk area on the ground surface. And with the further development of the cavity approaching the ground surface, we will see the collapse of the ground and the formation of sinkhole.
Is this a natural phenomenon?
Well, it can be a natural phenomenon and a man-made phenomenon. For natural phenomenon, the sinkholes normally formed in a limestone formation, like where this piece of rock from. And in man-made case, underground construction can induce sinkholes because we are disturbed the stability of underground rocks and the environment and induce the damage of a rock crossing the settlements or collapse of the ground.
So doctor, in the case of what's happened in KL, what do you think could be the cause?
So a large part of Kuala Lumpur is situated on a limestone formation, which is rich in cavities, sinkholes and underground streams. Those areas are very, very sensitive to underground water. No matter it's natural water or the water leaked from the underground pipes. And those cases can flush the soil away and disturb the ground surface instability, making the sinkholes.
Doctor, we've seen the footage of the woman walking along the road. The road looks normal, it's quite smooth. How could it be that she suddenly fell into a sinkhole?
I believe if a sinkhole is developing on the ground, there must have some deformation on the ground surface. But this deformation can be very small. A normal person may not be able to detect it.
How can someone prevent themselves from falling into a sinkhole?
So we need to be careful while walking. We need to avoid the sunken areas with visible cracks. And we also need to pay attention to the areas with warning signs.
And doctor, how could another sinkhole have appeared so quickly around it?
It's difficult to see those sinkholes are related or connected. It could be independent, but as far as we know, there is a limestone area. There could be many cavities on the ground. They are developing all the time. But what we can do is to have a close monitoring to detect the acceleration of the ground deformation, and that we can predict upcoming sinkholes.
And how is this detection done?
So we can use some imaging processing technique to process the video recordings with the assistance of artificial intelligence and machine learning. We can convert the imaging information into the deformation information of the ground. If we see the deformation is getting accelerated, that means this area is become more unstable, risky, and we should be careful about this area.
Are buildings near sinkholes compromised? Could this happen?
It's possible if the sinkhole is significant and close to the building can be compromised by the sinkhole.
So how do we fix a sinkhole?
If we have a sinkhole, we can inject the cement grouts to fill it up. But in the long term, it's difficult for us to prevent sinkholes because many sinkholes may form around it.
Why do you think we're seeing more news about sinkholes lately?
I think there are several reasons. One is related to climate change because we have more heavy rains and acidic water flowing on the ground. to promote the dissolution of soluble minerals and rocks, creating big cavities and induce the formation of sinkholes. And the second reason is underground construction may disturb the underground climate and induce the instability of soils and the rocks, and that could destabilize the ground stability.
Will Singapore have the same problem? Could this happen here?
I don't think so. The reason is because Singapore has solid, strong bedrocks covered by residual soil and deposited soil. In other words, our foundation is stronger than that in Kuala Lumpur. We don't know any strong current in the subsurface that could flush away those soil formations.
But Doctor, we see so much construction going on around the island. Is it safe?
Because Singapore has a very high standard of road construction and underground construction, there is unlikely to have any damage of the pipes and the road collapse that induces sinkholes. But we still need to monitor the potential damage.
So if I fell into a sinkhole, what could happen to me?
The best scenario is you will just drop into a deep hole. If you're unlucky, you can be flushed away to reservoir or open sea. It depends on where the current leads to.
And that's all for this episode on sinkholes. If you have any questions, leave us a comment and subscribe for the next episode. We'll see you soon.